大家跟我一起读一二三，但以理啊，你们要隐藏这话，封闭这书，直到末时，必有多人来往奔跑，知识就必增长。我们做祷告，天父，感谢赞美你，把今天的道、今天的讲台、今天的信息交在圣所里面，圣灵你亲自来告诉我们，来感动我们，让我们看见，给我们一个受教的心，给我们眼睛能够看见，耳朵能够听见。你的话语，因为你说凡有耳的必听当听，不是没有个没有有人长耳朵却没有听见的功能。今天我求主你打开这听见的功能在我们当中，让我们能够看到和听见，奉耶稣的名。So 我们看到在但以理的时候，他从里搬出来 ，OK， 但以理的时候，他有讲一句预言说，到末世的时候必有许多人来往奔跑，知识就必增长。我们来看几样东西，就是说当你预言说在末世的时代有两个特征，第一个什么都讲速度 ，OK， 速度包括时空啊、交通啊。第二是知识，知识会很多，知识不只是一个书本上的知识，是科技和资讯会要爆棚的一个情况。我们今天的时代是怎么样？我们来看一些它的解释。OK， 来往奔跑的希伯来原文的意思就是快速航行到远处。以前我们不能快速航行到远处，要到 America 坐船都要坐两个月、一个月。现在我们坐 Asia， everyone can fly， 一下子就到了。OK。所以知识的又按错了，按错了。哎，知识的希伯来原文就是资讯或者知识上的优越，就是超越了，就是增加的希伯来原文就是说丰富地、奇妙地、额外地的加多。所以把整刚才我们读的经文来解释，用今天的话语来解释，在末世人类会借着创世以来从未有过的科技发达和资讯爆炸，快速地在全球传递。这句预言已经在今天应验了。OK， 但以理讲这句话说是在主前的七百年加上两千年，是2700年前讲的这句话。我们今天在克林这里面的，我们来看下去 next， video。
This is his first coming. The angel Gabriel, who gave Daniel the information about the Messiah's second coming, said that the understanding of the timing of the second coming was sealed until the time of the end. In other words, it could not be understood until this special period of history in which we are living. But in addition to other clues, Gabriel gave two conditions that would prevail at the time of the end. Travel and knowledge or information would be vastly increased, according to Daniel's prophecy. Interestingly, the Hebrew word for running to and fro literally means to travel great distances. The Hebrew word for knowledge means not only knowledge, but information and the clever dissemination of that knowledge. The Hebrew word for increase literally means an abundant, surprising increase or addition. So a more modern rendition of this prophecy could then be stated something like this. In the very last days, man's ability to travel and traverse the earth will explode with technology. Information systems and information dispersion will increase like the world has never known. Out of the 10,000 years of human existence, for 9,900 of those years, man has walked, ridden beast, or built carts and wagons pulled by beasts. Only in the last 100 years or so did man go from animal travel to mechanical and mass transportation systems. Only in the last 60 years or so has man traveled into space. Practically everyone on the globe now has access to world travel for the first time in human history, and only in our lifetime. But that is only the first half of the prophecy. Education and knowledge has also exploded in the 20th century. From the time of Christ until 1900, it is estimated that man's knowledge has doubled. In just the next 50 years, from 1900 to the late 1940s, it reportedly doubled again. Then man's knowledge began an extremely rapid doubling, first every 7 years, then every 2 years, beginning in the 1960s. It appears that the late 1940s or the early 1950s marked the time in history when knowledge and education and information vastly increased and literally began exploding. This explosion of knowledge just happens to correspond exactly to the rebirth of Israel in 1948. And the fourth amazing end time prophecy that we are now living is from the mouth of Jesus himself. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then the end will come. When Jesus spoke these words, the gospel was not yet completed. He had not yet gone to the cross. There was no empty tomb. The Holy Spirit had not been given. The church had not been born. The whole world had not been discovered yet, and the technology to take the gospel to the world had not been invented. But he spoke the words as an end time prophecy, and now it is happening. Again, we are the only generation that has ever lived that is witnessing the gospel being preached to the entire world by information technologies invented only in the last 20 years. Now is the time of the end, according to Jesus himself.
Thank you, 开灯。都开，我给你看这个 video 故事来影响你啊，这是影验了耶稣所讲的。你活在这个资讯爆棚的时代，也就是所有的福音才能够传遍。现在以前两千年前要传福音的一个地方去一个地方很慢，现在 internet 一按到全国，全世界我出名的公益，还有其他的那些布道家都在已经在讲到了。Ryan Harkin, Benny Hinn 这些人都在讲到了，所以这天国的福音传遍天下，末期就到来了。哪有人没有听过耶稣？只有不信耶稣，没有人没有听过耶稣的。只有那些那个原住民土著，我们还在努力当中，因为我们不能跟他沟通，讲不到他的话，只能讲，可能讲方言才能够听得到。所以我们会看到未来的日子。这个已经来到，这未来日子或者今天的日子已经是末期了。